Greetings, citizens of YouTube. Recently there has been a downfall in quality of content uploaded. There are many reasons for this, but one thing is clear. This will change very soon, and I sincerely apologize for letting many of you down. Ironman is the heart of this channel and something that must return. For this reason, Operation Ultimate will be taking effect very soon. What is Operation Ultimate, you ask? Well, sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. By the way, my microphone is broken at the moment, but this text-to-speech is pretty epic, Kappa.
Darling, darling, I'll turn the lights back on now. Watching, watching, as the credits all roll down. And crying, crying, you know we're playing to a full house. House. No heroes, villains, one to blame. While wilted roses fill the stage, and the thrill is gone. Our debut was a masterpiece, but in the end, for you and me, hold this show, it can't go on. We used to have it all, but now's our curtain call. So hold for the applause. Oh, 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 oh. Wave out to the crowd and take our final bow. Oh, it's our time to go, but at least we stole the show. 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 At least we stole the show.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Ultimate Ironman has arrived. As mentioned in the beginning, I apologize for the last few videos. They were rushed and I really didn't have my heart in them. So from now on, it will be back to the good old Ironman. This time with a twist, as I have always wanted to try out an Ultimate Ironman, but always seen it as a bit too much of a challenge. So I decided to make an Ultimate Ironman PKer. Some interesting logic there, I'll agree. Anyway, this series should be entertaining to watch and certainly provide some challenges for myself along the way, with potentially many frustrating moments. As you saw in the beginning, the goal is to achieve a tier 10 emblem by getting 10 target kills without dying. If you guys have any questions, suggestions, or advice for the series, do put them down in the comment section and I'll be sure to read all of them. I really hope you guys do enjoy this series. I have about 10 weeks left until university, so I really want to establish a good series. Alright, well, without further ado, let's begin.
Logic. Got a date with destiny. My heart says yeah, but can't convince the rest of me. I tried so hard to make it with no recipe. My selfish ways caught up and got the best of me. I need redemption, no need to mention my past. Cause all that matters now is bigger than diamonds and cash. The glitz, the glamour, the lights, the camera, the action. The stage, the fans, the speakers blasting. You know I want it, I need it, don't doubt it, I can't live without it. This is everything I've dreamed of, it's everything I've ever wanted. But is it really truly in my plans? But did God mix up my blueprints? Did he have it right there in his hands? Anybody give me a hint? I can feel it now, I know it's coming. And I don't give a fuck what anybody say. I'm falling, I'm risen, I chose and selected, dismissing. Incarceration through these bars created a prison. And I intend to do the time that the sentence is given. 25 to life, yeah, that's how I'm living. Sometimes I wonder if I'll ever make it. But there's only one way I'ma know. I'm like a seed planted in the dirt. Feels like I've been waiting forever to grow. And maybe today is the day. And maybe tonight is the night. But one thing that I know for sure, this time I'ma get it right.
Thank you.
So it's at this point that the potentially frustrating moments begin to occur. As you'll see, I end up getting rinsed by the moss giants during the waterfall quest and then comboed by some Mogtime mammoths when trying to rebuild. Thankfully, I managed to complete the waterfall quest and regain some of my money, mainly by collecting steel plate buddies and then selling them in Varrok. I then invested some of that money, bought about 1,000 fire strikes to use at fire giants in order to try and get myself a rune skim. So that's what I'm going to be doing for now. Hopefully we can get fairly lucky and we'll see if we can pick one up.
Darling, darling, you know that we are sold out. This is fading, but the band plays on now.
Well, as you guys can see, I'm actually quite close to 55 magic, which I said I was going to stop at if I didn't get a rune skim. As you will see, I actually just got myself a rune battle axe. Now that is from the rare drop table, which is kinda strange, and I'm not sure what I'm gonna do now because I could possibly use that to train with. I'm not sure how much worse it is than a rune skim, but potentially I might just stay here until 55 magic, and then if we don't get it, we'll go back to, I think, Hunter possibly. I'll say go back, we'll start Hunter, and I will get myself a rune skim from Ninja Implings, so hopefully we can get one soon, but that is pretty damn strange. Oh my god. About 3 kills later, we get the bloody rune skim. Yes, boys, we actually freaking got it. That is beautiful. Well, we've got ourselves some spare casts left over, so I'm sure we'll use those somewhere else, but as you can see, I ended up with a rune skim and rune battle axe. Not sure if I'll keep the battle axe, I'll probably sell it to get myself some extra GP, but that's where I'm going to be ending episode 1, guys. I hope you are all really looking forward to this series. I've certainly had fun making it in this first episode. If you do enjoy it, please do drop me a like and show some support down below. It's hugely appreciated, and I'll see you guys very soon for episode 2.